hope that you've had a great week and I've had loads and loads of fun.
It's that time again.
Here we go. Hello.
Good morning, agents.
Hello, how can we help you?
Your mission today, with the help of those at home, if you choose to accept it, is to solve the mystery of the scrambled letters. You will be shown a series of 7 images. Your task is to find all the letters in the images and unscramble them to discover today's theme.
It should be interesting.
A package will be arriving shortly containing the images and your spy supplies. This device will self-destruct in 10.
Here we go again.
Buying a new phone every week is getting really expensive.
Why does he have to blow it up every time?
Well, we better get going.
Go on then, see what we've got.
Here we go again. A bag of doom.
Oh no.
Let's see. Okay. 7 envelopes.
What's inside then?
I think there's a picture. I think we need to get ready.
Let's do it. The letter? Right, letter number 2. Should we have a go at letter number 3? Time for number 4. Number 5. Right, now that we've got all the letters, let's see if we can unscramble and see what word we've got. Right, let's see what the letters are. We've got C, H, O, I, C, E, S.
Oh, choices.
That must be today's theme.
Every day we make so many choices. We choose what we're going to have for breakfast, what we're going to wear, what we're going to do with our day, maybe choosing which game to play or what TV show to watch. We can also make choices about how we act. Are you going to be patient and understanding when somebody annoys you, or are you going to get angry? Are you going to share your treats with your brother or your sister, or keep them to yourself? Our days are full of choices, and sometimes we make good choices, and sometimes we make bad choices.
There are many situations we may face which are completely out of our control, but the one thing we do have control over is how we respond to those situations. The choices we make matter. They are important, and here is why.
Firstly, choices have consequences. Every choice we make has a consequence, something good, something bad. For example, if we choose not to do our homework, we might get into trouble with a teacher, get low grades. Equally, if you choose to work hard, the consequence will be that you do well.
The second reason that the choices we make matter is that our choices can affect others, sometimes in a good way and sometimes in a bad way. For example, if you choose not to get out of bed on time when you're getting a lift to school, it may mean that the person taking you to school is late for work. Equally, we could choose to get up with plenty of time to get ready and make sure that everyone is on time and happy. The choices we make don't only affect us, but others too. Philippians 2 verse 3 to 4 says, "When you do things, do not let selfishness or pride be your guide, but be humble and give more honour to others than to yourself. Do not be interested only in your own life, but be interested in the lives of others." This verse reminds us that we need to be wise and consider others when we make choices.
Thirdly, it's important to understand that your choices don't define you. There will be a point in all of our lives where we make the wrong choice. We all make mistakes, and this is part of learning and growing up. It's important to remember that these choices don't define who you are. It's important to hold on to how God sees us, even when we make mistakes. Micah 7, verses 18 to 19 says, "There is no God like you. You forgive people who are guilty of sin. You don't look at the sins of your people who are left alive. You, Lord, will not stay angry forever. You enjoy being kind. Lord, you will have mercy on us again. You will conquer our sins. You will throw away our sins into the deepest sea." This verse reminds us of an important truth. God will always love us, always want the best for us, and that even when we make mistakes, God's love for us doesn't change. But that doesn't mean that we should just stop trying. God wants what is best for us and wants us to make good choices.
Fourthly, every experience builds our character. When we go through hard times, we are in the best position to grow and learn. In Romans 5, verse 3 to 5, it says, "We also have joy with our troubles because we know that these troubles produce patience, and patience produces character, and character produces hope. And this hope will never disappoint us because God has poured out his love to fill our hearts. God gave us his love through the Holy Spirit whom God has given to us." So whatever you may face in school, good or bad, these experiences can either break you or shape you. When we make the choice to face these difficult times with a positive attitude and make good choices, it can shape us and build character.
And finally, choices give us an opportunity to look to God. Sometimes we might struggle to make the right decisions or not know what the right decision is. This is an opportunity to seek God and let Him guide you. Proverbs 3 verses 5 to 6 says, "Trust the Lord completely. Don't depend on your own knowledge. With every step you take, think about what He wants, and He will help you go the right way." This verse reminds us that God walks with us. He shows us the right way to go. So when we find ourselves in a position where we have to make difficult choices, we can look to God to help and guide us.
We have an activity that you can do to help you think about the sort of choices that you would like to make this next school year. So, grab a piece of paper and draw around your hand. Then, in each of the fingers, write down something that you are going to choose to do this new school year. It may be things like work hard, smile more, forgive quickly, read my Bible more, take up dancing, whatever that might be for you. You can decorate it and put it up somewhere that you can see it so that each day you can be reminded of the choices that you want to make.
Before we close our time together today, let's pray. Father God, thank you so much for loving us, despite the things that we may do wrong sometimes. I pray that for this coming year, we choose to look to you to guide us with all the decisions we have to make. Amen.
Amen. Thank you for joining us this morning. We hope that you enjoyed it. Take care, and we will see you again very soon.
Bye.